Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great PowerPoint tip for you today. I'm going to use PowerPoint for the web. I'm going to go to slide 2, my agenda slide, type in some bullets, and I'm going to automatically create the other title slides from those bullets. Let's dive into this video. I've got PowerPoint for the web running. I went to office.com and signed in and clicked on PowerPoint, and I got a blank presentation. Slide 1 is your title slide. It usually has the title of your presentation, your name, and possibly your job title and the date of it. Just to save time, I'm going to do copy and paste. I'm speaking at an administrative professional day conference in April of this year. So I know you can't see that, but it's got a white font behind it, but I'm going to come over here to Designer. In case you're wondering, how did you get to Designer? Designer. And I'm going to just click on something, except I don't want that one. It's got a video in it. Let me pick something else. That works right there. And I'm not going to sit here and add the subtitle. Back home in the top left, here comes the cool trick. New slide. Slide 2 is usually title and content. Sometimes it'll be two content, but I'm going to go with title and content. This is going to be my agenda slide. Sometimes you call this the outline slide. Usually all the other slides run from here. So whatever bullets I have here become a slide title for the next slides. So watch this cool trick. My presentation is going to be covering Microsoft Teams. Well, in Microsoft Teams, we've got chat, we've got channel conversation, we've got files, we've got the activity feed, we've got meetings, scheduling meetings. I'm not going to sit here and type every one of those, so I'm going to just do a few. Chats, channel conversations, files, meetings. I'm going to leave it right here. Watch this. Look over to the far right. Add next 4 slides automatically. If I backspace through meetings, add 3 slides automatically. Let me put meetings back in here. I guess I could have done an undo. One more. I'm also going to talk about scheduling, whether you want to schedule in Outlook or Teams. That works. And I'm like, sure, I do want to add those slides. So here I go. That is the coolest trick to me. So very cool trick. Adding the agenda slide comes up with these other slides. And then from here, if you don't like it, you can come in here and quickly go ahead and change the design or whatever you want to do for your different slides. If I go back to Designer and I don't like it, I can come in here and change them also, just so you know that. All right, that was it. I'm going to stop. So we created slides from the agenda slide, and I showed you in PowerPoint for the web where the Designer tab is, and here is Designer right here. Real cool quick tip, if you haven't caught it, my video is up in the top right, how to throw a Word document, Word on the web, into PowerPoint automatically. Feel free to subscribe. If you have any questions about this PowerPoint video, please let me know. And if you happen to be around for Administrative Professional Day, I will be at the University of Georgia speaking in April. Thank you. Bye.